नियमरहितान् श्लाघैकमयी अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती गायैर्जयति. वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् विरुद्ध बोत् प्रसिद्धिविरुद्ध एण्ड् विद्याविरुद्ध. वि लुक्ड् एट् विद्याविरुद्धं वन् आफ् दिस् थिङ्ग् देट् वि सा वास् धर्मशास्त्रविरुद्धं. देर् वास् अ क्वश्चन् अबौट् वेदर् रावण, यु नो, इफ् द केरेक्टर् ईस् अधार्मिक, if the character himself, if Ravana, for example, the description of Ravana taking Sita or some other adharma vishaya that has happened, but the character himself does it, if the character is supposed to be an adharmika, or if a dharmavan is supposed to do just one adharma work, see, it is not a if it's a character fault, then it's okay. The poet has the responsibility to portray the character as it is. But if it is the, if it tells us the ignorance of the kavi, he is describing a great pandita and he says that pandita is doing ratri snanam, then it is a fault. If he wants to show that the pandita is actually a very great pandita and there is one fault in him, because of which he ends up in some narakam or he ends up getting some in getting a papam, then it is not a dosha. It is a dosha where it involves the ignorance of the poet. He should not write something which is completely different from the shastra. So there are many shastras, and according to that's why when he starts off in the first Ullasa itself, when Mammata talks about the kavi prayojanam, he says shaktir nipunata loka shastra kavyat vyavekshanat. So shaktihi nipunata loka shastra kavyadi avekshanat. Like a poet, before he is a poet, he has to first understand how the world functions, lokam, and then shastram. He should know every shastra that is there, what are all the rules laid down by the shastram. He also should know about kavya, how mahakavis have written kavya in there. So kavya shastradi avekshanat, by deeply analyzing shastram, kavyam and the world around him, he should write a kavya. That is how he can get a nipunata. So here he should know the rules of the shastram, and without knowing the rules of the shastram, if he just puts in something like that ratri snanam, then it is a dosham. If he is describing an adharmic action of the character itself, then there is no dosham there. Okay, now this is arthashastra viruddham ananya sadrisham yasya balam bahvo samikshyate. Yes, okay.
So if we were to take the adharmic, for example, if we take Ravana, for example, and yes, if the poet portrays him in the same shloka, saying Ravana had taken a bath then at night, then that yes, is not incorrect.
That is not incorrect. It is not a dosha, it is a guna. If, you know, he is a person who can do, because the Rakshasa, even doing Sandhya Vandanam at the time of 10 or 11 is supposed to be a Rakshasa Vela, and you're not supposed to do Sandhya Vandanam then. And if Ravana is a person who is displaying those characters and he wants to, the poet wants to portray him like that, then yes, it is not a dosham, it is a gunam.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But the problem is, he is a very, very correct person. Ravana does everything according to Shastra. The only thing he did not adhere to was Paradhara Abhigamana. That's how Ramayana talks about him. Right? So we have to look for some other character here. Ananya sadrisham yasya balam bahoho samikshyate shadgunya anusritihi tasya satyam sa nishprayojana. Etat arthashastrena viruddham. Ananya sadrisham yasya balam yasya bahoho balam ananya sadrisham samikshyate. This is in praise of a king, and a king whose arm strength, bahoho balam, is incomparable. Ananya sadrisham samikshyate is seen as being incomparable. There is nobody else equal to nobody has such a strength which is equal to this person's strength, this king's strength. फॉर हिम सा षाड्गुण्य अनुसृतिः तस्य फॉर दैट किंग राज्ञः सा षाड्गुण्य अनुसृतिः षाड्गुण्यम इज सिक्स डिविजन्स ऑफ पॉलिटी नीतिशास्त्रम विच इज संधि विग्रह यानम आसनम द्वैधी भावः संश्रयः दीज आर द सिक्स टाइप ऑफ गुण दैट अ किंग हैज टू फॉलो इवन इफ ही इज पावरफुल So, but here he says shatgunya anusritihi following of the shatgunyam is useless nishprayojana that is not the point in an earlier shloka also he says where those kings who rely only on their arm strength are fools those who rely only on their niti shastram are also it is not appropriate so only a king who relies on both niti shastram and his strength is or his army is bhavadrishah dvitrah eva pavitram asmin jagati remember that shloka for this so shatgunya anusritihi nishprayojana iti arthashastra viruddham etat balavadapi nripah balavanapi shatgunyam anusaret that is your niti next is kama shastra viruddham vidhaya dure keyuram ananga anganam angana बभार कांतेन कृताम करज उल्लेख मालिकाम अनंग अंगणम अंगना केयूरम दूरे विधाय कांतेन कृताम करज उल्लेख मालिकाम बभार इज टॉकिंग ऑफ अ नायिका हू हैज दिस द नेल मार्क्स ऑफ हर कांता ऑफ हर बिलवेड शी डज नॉट वेयर दिस केयूरम केयूरम इज दट वंकी buja what you wear on your you know arms that is keyuram so that vanki she removes it dure vidhaya she throws away her bracelet or that aabharanam how is this lady ananga anganam angana angana esha nayika anangasya anganam iva varta anganam eva she is like the vilasasthanam of manmatha this lady who is like the vilasasthanam of manmatha keyuram dure vidhaya she throws away her keyuram her vanki that aabharanam and what does she wear in its place instead of that aabharanam she wore babhara a row of nakhakshata karaja kare jayate iti karaja nakha नख नखानाम उल्लेख दट नेल मार्क्स मालिका रो ऑफ दोज नेल मार्क्स फ्रॉम हर बिलवेड कांतेन कृताम नख उल्लेख मालिकाम नखक्षतानाम मालाम सा धरति हियर केयूरपदे नखक्षतम न विहितम इति एतत् कामशास्त्रेण विरुद्धम इट इज इन अपोज्ड टू कामशास्त्र Why that the place where that vanki is placed there you don't have nakakshatam there is a rule in kama shastram where it says in vatsayana shastra nakakshatasya sthanani kakshau vakshas tatha galaha parshau jaganamuruja stana ganda lalatikaha the places where nail marks can happen during rati during a union is kakshau arm under the arm so the armpits you know where it is not on the arm but under that so vakshah chest tata galaha neck parshvau sides jaghanam hips uru thai stana ganda lalatika stana ganda is also neck portion lalatika is forehead these are the places where you can have the nakakshatam but not anywhere else That is in Kama Shastra. So this is Kama Shastra Viruddham. Keyura Sthane Nakakshata Vidyamanatvat. Atra Kama Shastra Yena Viruddham Asti. The other Shastram is Yoga Shastram. This is a little bit tougher shloka. There are many yoga terms. It's more like, what is that? Aprastutama. There is another Eka Shastra Eva Prasiddhatvam. You can even take that here. so difficult so ashtanga yoga parishilana kilanena dusadha siddhi savidham vidadad vidure asadayanna abhimatam adhuna viveka khyatim samadhi dhana mauli manihi vimuktaha samadhi dhana mauli manihi adhuna vimuktaha so your main sentence समाधि धनं समाधिरेव धनं यस्य येषां तेषां मौलिमणिरिव यः विराजते योगी. मौलिमणिः चूडामणिः. योगी shines forth like the chudamani, like a crest jewel, crown jewel among all those yogis who treat samadhi as a dhanam, as the treasure. Samadhireva dhanam yesham te, yesham yoginam, teshu yogishu madhye, ayam yogihi maulimani riva yaha virajate, saha aduna vimuktaha, moksham upagataha. Katham? अष्टाङ्गयोगपरिशीलनकीलनेन अष्टाङ्गयोग देर् आर् एट् डिविजन्स् इन् योग ही हेस् अनलैस्ड् इट् वेरि वेल् अण्ड् तत् परिशीलनेन कीलनं कीलनम् इस् हिस् इस् बै यु नो डीप्ली अनलैसिङ्ग् दि अष्टाङ्गयोगम् yes so after deeply analyzing the ashtanga yoga the different methods he has set apart dure vidadat he has removed that dussadha siddhi savidham dussadha siddhi is mukti which is very difficult to attain and near to that is your actually nirvikalpaka samadhi now okay before I go into this I have to show you the path of everything so yoga is called samadhi is called chittavritti nirodha the different chittavritti is the different thoughts that arise in our mind that is your chittavritti so manovritti nam nirodha staganam the stop or rodha of all the type different thoughts that are there in your mind is called samadhi so it is a general term that you say and for to attain that samadhi to attain that status of a yogi there are several steps involved in yoga yoga talks about first is viveka khyati viveka khyati in this shloka he says dussada siddhi savidam after removing nirvikalpaka samadhi abhimatam viveka khyatim asadayanna he takes viveka khyati which is a technical term and aduna asadayanna after attaining viveka khyati he now has attained moksha so the entire process is actually reversed here so let's look at each word first is viveka khyatihi viveka is discriminating power to understand what is prakriti and what is purusha purushaha is atma swarupam it is a parallel in vedanta is atma swarupam whereas in yoga and sankhya it is purusha it is termed as purusha the difference between purusha and prakriti prakriti is the cause for everything that we see in the world purusha is just the atma swarupam starting from buddhi tattvam manas jagat everything else is the has been created by prakriti we have to understand the difference between prakriti and purusha first without even the knowledge that whatever that we see in this world is ephemeral it is no it is not eternal it can be destroyed and it is there is no relationship between the atma swarupam and this prakriti you have to first understand the difference between that is called viveka khyati vivekasya jnanam khyati jnanam so viveka jnanam ityukte bhinnatva jnanam kau bhinnau prakriti purushau bhinnau iti jnanam viveka khyatih so that is the first step it is an intellectual perception that the purusha and the prakriti are different the next is you enter in you follow yama niyama asana pranayama pratyahara dharana dhyana and samadhi which are the eight different stages of yoga first is yama which is outer sense organs you have to control of outer sense organs niyama control of the manas asana you perform the different types of asanas that yoga prescribes pranayama control of breath pratyahara you don't involve your you take in your breath and the buddhi and everything and pratyaharam is control dharana you keep it steady in concentrating upon the purusha dhyana is a forcible more a deeper concentration samadhi is divided into two which is savikalpaka samadhi and nirvikalpaka samadhi savikalpaka is where you have the difference of I am concentrating my mind or my buddhi upon that self, that Atman or that Purusha. So there still exists those three things. Dhyana, Dhyatru, Dhyeya. Dhyeya Vastu, Purushaha. Dhyata, Aham, Dhyanam, Karomi. Dhyanam is the process. So Dhyana, Dhyatru, Dhyeya, Triputi Karanam, which is your Savikalpaka. There is a difference in that, even in that end stage of Samadhi. The second part of that samadhi is your nirvikalpaka samadhi, which is where nothing, none of these three are present and you have only the atmaswarupa which is there. That is your nirvikalpaka samadhi. So that is the final stage before mukti. Now in the shloka, what does he say? Dussada siddhi savidham, that stage which is very close to siddhi, moksha, which is the nirvikalpaka samadhim, dure kritva, I am removing it. He is in fact not saying that this is the reason for mukti, but he is saying this is not the reason for mukti. I can attain mukti even with the first stage, which is the viveka khyati. Abhimatam viveka khyatim asadayan. After just getting an intellectual perception of what is different and the difference between prakriti and purusha, this yogi has attained mukti. He has removed nirvikalpaka samadhi from his process by what? By analyzing and having established Ashtanga Yoga. The entire process is reversed now. You get it? So Ashtanga Yoga Parishilana Keelanena Nirvikalpaka Samadhim Asadayanna Mukti Vimuktaha Abhavate. That's how the shloka should be. It is completely Yoga Shastrena Viruddham. So the vritti here is Atra Viveka Khyatihi Tataha Sampragnata Samadhihi. Sampragnata Samadhi, where your buddhi is still acting, which is your Savikalpaka Samadhihi. Paschat Asampragnataha, where there are no attributes in that, which is the Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. Tataha Muktihi. Only after that a yogi can attain moksha. Natu viveka khyato. It is not because of viveka khyati, immediately you cannot jump to mukti. There are four other steps in between. Etat yoga shastrena viruddham. Evam vidyantarairapi viruddham udaharyam. In the same manner, you can take examples from other vidyas also, so other shastra also. Next one is anavikritam. There is nothing new. The same thing is being said again and again. My problem, he takes from Bhartrihari's Vairagya Sadakam, example for the dosham. Prapta shriyas sakala kama dughas tatah kim dattam padam shirasi vidbushatam tatah kim santarpitah pranayino vibhavais tatah kim kalpam stitam tanubhritam tanubhis tatah kim. Atra tatah kim iti na navikritam. He uses the word tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim in all four padas. Again and again he repeats it. So meaning of the shloka is you have attained Bhartrihari is, you know, talking, is ridiculing the people who are there. Who have attained everything that they need to. Now, what are you going to do? What is the next step? But they are clueless as to what they should do after that. So, sakala kama dugaha shriyaha praptaha. Sakala kama dugaha, the dogdhi, sarvana kamana dogdhi shriyaha. So, shrihi. The wealth that can give you or satisfy every desire that is there in you, you have attained such great, immense wealth. Tatah kim? What are you going to do after that? You have achieved everything that you have to. You have so much of wealth in your life that you can get anything that you desire. You can even have 12 jets in your backyard, private jets in your backyard. Now what? Tatah kim? He's questioning, you know. What is the purpose in your life then, after that? Dattam padam shirasi vidvishatam. Vidvishatam shirasi padam dattam. You have placed your foot on top of the heads of all your enemies. That is, you have won over all your enemies. Tatah kim? You don't have any enemy in this world. What are you going to do after that? Pranayanaha vibhavaihi santarpitaha. You are not a stingy person. You have taken your wealth and you have satisfied all your affectionate people. Those people who are all affectionate and surrounding you, you have satisfied everybody. Santarpitaha. You have pleased everyone with your wealth, with your dana, dharma, etc. Tatah kim. Punyam cha arjitam, tatah kim. Kalpam sthitam tanubhritam tanubihi tatah kim. Tanubihi, tanubhritam tanubihi. If you have your sharira, you have your body, you have used medicine, kaya kalpam and all that, and you have attained animadi siddhayaha, every siddhi that is there, anima, garima, laghima, everything. And then you have stayed for till the entire kalpam finishes, until pralaya kalam, you are assured that your body is not going to be destroyed. What are you doing towards moksha? It's a beautiful slokam. I have to say yes, because he keeps repeating tatakim, there is nothing new about it. He gives an example, counter example. Say, when if you look at Shankara's tatakim slokam, he says, Shariram surupam yathava kalatram yajas charu chitram dhanam merutulyam manaschenna lagnam guru rangri padme tatakim 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 tatakim. That is his shloka. It's, I don't know what the name of that shloka is. Chariram surupam. No?
Gurvashtakam makka.
Gurvashtakam. Yes. Every shloka will have that guru rangri padme. Manaschenna lagnam guru rangri padme tatakim tatakim. Chariram surupam. You have a beautiful form. Chariram surupam yathava kalatram. Just like how your wife is beautiful, you also have a very beautiful form. Shariram surupam yathava kalatram yasas charu chitram dhanam merutulyam. You have a great fame, yasas charu chitram dhanam merutulyam. Merutulyam dhanam asti bhava, haste manasche nalagnam guru rangripadme. Guroho angripadme manaha lagnam nachet. If your mind is not attached to the feet, lotus feet of the guru, then nothing else is needed in this world. That is, there is no prayojanam to the life in this. That's why guru is very important, he will say. Guru ranugnana inaiva purnaha bhavati pumana. You need guru. That is a different method, because he is trying to enforce that a guru is important. So without that, what is the prayojanam? Tatakim. There is no anavikritam there, no dosham. Whereas here, he uses the tatakim in every padam. So it is a na navikritam. A counter example is tattu yatha. Tattu yatha ityukte navikritam tu yatha. When it is portrayed in a very new manner, he gives the counter example where there is no dosham and it is a gunam. Yadi dahati analovatra kim adbhutam. Yadi cha gauravam adrishu kim tataha. Lavanam ambu sadaiva mahodadehe prakritireva satam avishadita. Satam avishadita prakritihi eva. Avishadita vishada yuktata vishada vishada yuktam yuktaha nasti. Sat, satpurushaha, good people always are happy or always are satisfied. When do you get dukkham? Because something is not satisfied. Because your desire is not satisfied, you feel upset about it. So for great people, they don't have any fervent desire. So they never display a grief. So avishadita, sukhita. Satam sukhita prakritihi eva. It's their nature to feel satisfied and happy. That is their nature. Just like yadi analaha dahati atrakim adbutam. If agni burns, what is the surprising factor in that? Kim adbutam atra? Adrishu gauravam iti yat kim tataha? What is the use if mountains are great? So what? If mountains are lofty, that is, they're very great. Gauravam, adrishu gauravam, kim tataha, so what? Ambu, mahodadehe, ambu, sadaiva lavanam eva. The samudrasya jalam, lavanayuktam, kshaaram eva, sarvada. The ocean's water is always salty. In the same manner, satam prakritihi. See, kim adbutam, kim tataha, sadaiva lavanam, all of these and prakriti reva. He has just expressed that tatak kim in four different ways. He has not repeated it. So, atra navikritam asti, kintu praptashriyaha iti shloke tu anavikritam. But I like the way he says that. Tatak kim. Next one is sa niyama parivrittam. Parivrittam is a very tricky dosham that he says. There are four types of parivrittam: sa niyama, aniyama, vishesha, and avishesha. Let's look at sa niyama first. Sa niyamena vaktum uchitam, aniyamena uktam. If something has to be said with nirdharanam or with a particular word, otherwise the meaning would not be conveyed properly, whereas it is not been done like that. Aniyamena uktaha. Sa niyamena uktam. Tasmat artha parivrittam. Artham, it's not clear. The meaning is not conveyed in a very clear manner. Yatra anullikhitarthameva nikilam nirmanam etadvidehe utkarsha pratiyogi kalpanamapi nyakkara kotif para yataf pranabhritam manoratha gatihi ullanghya yatsampadaha tasyabhasa manikrita ashmasu manehe ashmatvameva uchitam. Yatra, he's talking about chintamani here. Chintamani is a type of wish giving jewel. Chintaratna vibhushitam. Devi Parvati's simhasanam is supposed to be made with chintamani. So whenever we think of Parvati, she has the capability of giving any desire that we want. Something that we don't even know that we want, she will give it. So chintaratna vibhushitam. Here he is talking about such a chintamani here. Yatra, yatra chintamani vishaye. Chintamani vishaye, anu, etat nikhilam videhe nirmanam anullikhitartham eva. Anullikhitartham aprayojanartham eva. Videhe nirmanam, videhe brahmanaha nirmanam, etat nikhilam jagat, sarvam aprayojanam eva chintamani vishaye. When we look at, in the view of Chintamani, everything that we see, all this creation, the entire creation, Brahma's creation is useless. Yatra cha utkarsha pratiyogi kalpanam api para nyakkara kotihi. Utkarsha pratiyogi. Utkarsham, its greatness, its excellence. Pratiyogi, something that is opposed to its excellence. That is, if at some point in the future that there can come another jewel which is greater than Chintamani, which is Utkarsha Atishaya Yuktam Asti Iti Kalpanameva. Or there can occur something which can remove its Utkarshatvam. Utkarsha Pratiyogi Ityukte Chintamani, the excellence that is there in Chintamani can go away, can vanish. Abhavam, utkarshasya abhava kalpanameva, atra nyakkara kotihi. It is a great insult to that Chintamani. One cannot think of the existence of Chintamani without its excellence or without the quality of it being able to give us our wishes. So utkarsha pratiyogi can be interpreted in two ways. One is that the very thought that Chintamani can exist without its excellence, without its capability, is a nyakkara koti, nyakkara insult. It is a great insult to that Chintamani. Or there can arise another mani, which is a pratiyogi, which is like a virodhi to this, that kalpanam, even that very thought of it is an insult to this Chintamani. Pranabhritam manoratha gatihi ullangya yat sampadaha yataha. Yasya chintamanehe sampadaha. The wealth that we get from its riches, the money, the chintamani's riches exceed ullangya. Manoratha gatihi ullangya. Pranabhritam manoratha gatihi ullangya. It has exceeded yataha. It has exceeded the desires of pranabhritam, these people, of regular living beings. if people have wanted something, it can give even beyond the desires of people. Ullangya yataha tasya abhasamani. See, if it is placed among gemstones which only resemble it, abhasa manikriteshu ashmasu madhye tasya chintamanehe tasya manehe ashmatvame ashmatvameva uchitam. Ashma means pebble, rock. You place it among these regular, you know, ruby, marakatam, and all these jewels are all there. And then you place this chintamani also among that without giving it a special place. Then that is also equal to a gem only. You only. Many ways to look at this shlokam. This is actually a very, very beautiful shlokam. Just to point out a dosha, he takes this. I can't even think of a dosham in this shloka. So what he is trying to say is, if you don't understand the value of a gem and you place it among normal gems, then you have to treat it as a stone only. Like how you, or a person who thinks of both Chintamani also as a rock, he also thinks of even, he thinks of all these, you know, Marakatam, Ruby, Pushparagam, all these Navaratnas are equal to only money, Ashma. Oh, they are not money for him. They are not valuable for him. They are all of no value at all. It is only equal to a stone for him. Be it even a Chintamani, it is only equal to a stone for him. Because he is a Mukta. I can only look at it as a Vedanti here. I'm saying, you know, for a person who looks of everything, even Abhasa Maniyekrita Ashmasu Api Asya Manehe Ashmatvameva Uchitam. For a person who does not know the value, you can take it like that also. Or if someone who does not know the value of Chintamani takes and puts it among other stones, then you have, it becomes only a stone. You have to treat it with greater value. That is one. So let's look at the dosham here. Okay. So abhasa mani kriteshu ityatra kshudra mani nam prayaha anya gunaha vartante. So what he means is, so abhasa matra mani kritam. When you say abhasa matrena, then abhasam means chaya matram. It only resembles that. It only resembles that money. It is not actual valuable money. All these gems that you see, like Marakatam, etc., all those only resemble money. It is only the Chintamani which is a money. So when you just say Abhasa Mani Krita means the stones that just look like stones, gems, stones that look like stems. It can be of a different value. But when you ninda paratve vaktavye, then you have to say abhasa matram, which means only a resemblance is there. There is no other good quality present in that gem for it to be called, for in that stone for it to be called as money. So here he gives an alternate reading to it. Chaya matra mani kritashmasu manehe tasyashmata eva uchita. When you put in the word, see the word matra is the word that gives us the idea of resemblance. If the word matra is not used and you just say abhasa mani krita, then the emphasis is lost. So niyamena yatra avadharana purvakam matrapadam vaktavyam tasmat nindaparatvam pratiyate tat atra na uktam iti karanat doshah. I hope it's clear. This is saniyama parivritta. Next one is aniyama parivritta. Yatra avadharanasya avashyakata na vidyate tatra avadharana rupa evakaraha uktaha. That is the next shloka. It's an opposite of the earlier one. Dosham. Opposite dosham. So, Vatram Bhojam Saraswati Adivasati Sada Shonayeva Adharaste Bahuhu Kakutstha Virya Smriti Karana Patuhu Takshinaste Samudraha Vahinyaha Parshvametaha Kshanamapi Bhavato नैव मुञ्चन्ति अभीक्ष्णं स्वच्छे अन्तर्मनसे मानसे अस्मिन् कथम् अवनिपते ते अम्बुपानाभिलाषः. ऐ नीड् टु टेक् द टेक्स्ट् वन् मिनिट् बिकास् द काण्टेक्स्ट् इस् वेरि नैस् इन् द टेक्स्ट्. This is from a natakam written by Bhoja. It's called Bhoja Prabandham, and it is written by Ballala, a poet, a natakakara. So Ballala virachite Bhoja Prabandhe I am उक्तिः, मगधस्य उक्तिः. सो मृगयायां दे आर् हण्टिङ्ग्, यू केन् लुक् फ्रम् हियर्. सो दे आर् हण्टिङ्ग् एण्ड् टू राजा, टू किङ्ग्स् आर् हण्टिङ्ग् देर्. दे आर् गोयिङ्ग् टुगेदर्. वन् इस् विक्रमार्क राजा, दि अदर् इस् मगधराजा. सो विक्रमार्कं राजानं प्रति मगधस्य उक्तिः ballala virachite bhoja prabandhe. So they are very this vikramarka raja is very thirsty, so he is asking for water. He is telling his servant to bring water. So he says yela ushira lavanga chandana lasat karpura kasturika jati patala ketakaihi surabhitam paniyam aniyatam. Paniyam aniyatam, brings surabhitam paniyam aniyatam, bring a fragrant water, because I'm very thirsty, bring this water which is fragrant with ela, elakai, cardamom, ushira, lavanga. All these are all things that make it both sheetalam. Chandana, karpura, kasturika, jati, patala, ketaka, flowers and everything have been put to make it very fragrant. It is also cold and very fragrant. So bring such a water to drink because we are all thirsty. So Vikramarka says this. When Magadha replies by saying, hey Avanipate, Rajan, Swachche Antar Manase Te Ambupana Abhilashaha Katham. Hey Avanipate, O King, I don't understand why you have such a desire to drink water. Because your mouth is where Saraswati resides. Vatram Bhojam Adivasati Saraswati. Saraswati resides in your mouth. Saraswati is the river here. Okay, or there are two meanings to it. One is Vagdevi Saraswati Tava Vatram Bhoje Vasati. Athava Saraswati Nadi Tava Vatram Bhojam Adivasati. The Slesha, he uses the double meaning to indicate that all the river bodies and the ocean is present in your mouth and in your at your sides, in your mind too. So ambupana abhilashaha katam asti bhavate. So vaktram bhojam saraswati adivasati sada sarvada te adharaha, your lips shonaha eva, it is very red. Red is one meaning. Shona is a nada. Nadaha, I think those rivers which go from north, flow north to south are called nada, and east to west are called nadi. So Narmada, nadi, and all these, there is a difference in that. So Shonaha is a nadaha. It is a tributary. So sada adharaha te shonaha. Eva, your lips are only that nadi shona, or it is only red. Bahuhu kakutstha virya smriti karana patuhu dakshinaste samudraha. Te dakshina bahuhu, your right hand reminds me of kakutstha virya smriti karana patuhu samudraha. It is the ocean, it is the southern ocean. Dakshinaha samudraha. Dakshinaha has to be used for both the bahu and the samudra. Your right hand is like the southern ocean, is indeed the southern ocean, which is capable of reminding us of Kakutstha Virya, Rama's Virya. Kakutstha, Rama's Virya. So why? He says, Shoshyam yadde samudram padyam gacchantu anaraha. Rama gets so angry that after 3 days, there is no reply from Samudra Raja that he will let give way for the entire army to walk to Lanka, he gets so angry that he says, Shoshyami Athava Padyam Gachantu Vanaraha, I will dry up the entire ocean, let the Vanarasena walk to Lanka. So angry about it. So in another shloka also he says, Janati Janati Tava Nama Ruchim Maheshaha Janatyamogha Patubana Gatim Payodihi Payodhihi Samudraha Ramasya Patu Bana Gatim Janati. He knows the strength of Rama. Samudra is well aware of it. He was so afraid that Rama will dry up him. So he immediately appears in front of Rama and says, you know, you build a bridge and I will ensure that it floats. So Kakutstha Virya Smriti Karana Patuhu Samudraha. Samudra Rajaha, Dakshina Samudra Rajaha. Te Bahuhu, your Bahu is like the ocean which remembers. So what he is trying to say is, your hand reminds me of Rama's Viryam. You are so powerful, and that Rama's Virya is the, when I look at the southern ocean, I am reminded of Rama who came here and built that Setu. So when I look at your ocean, when I look at your hand, Bahu, it is like the ocean. Etaha parshvam vahinyaha bhavataha parshvam kshanamapi abhikshnam naiva munchanti. Vahinyaha, vahini has two meanings. One is army, the other is nadi. So etaha nadyaha athava senaha. If you use the word sena, you won't get the meaning of nadi, vahini. So because he uses the word vahini, you get both meanings. So etaha parshvam, bhavataha parshvam, etaha vahinyaha. These vahini or sena that is there on the two sides of you, abhikshnam naiva munchanti, they never let go of your always sadaiva. Abhikshnam means sadaiva bhavataha parshvam na munchanti. They do not leave your side always. So we have some water body in every line. The last one is also like that. Antar manase, your mind is so clear, swache manase, like the Manas Sarovar. Like the Manasa Sarovar, your mind is also very clear. I don't understand how you have the desire for water. Ambubana avilashaha kutaha katham bhavitum arahati. Very clever shloka this is. Katham amanipate te ambubana avilashaha. So the dosham here is, shona atra shona eva iti niyamaha na vachyaha. So niyamaha na vachyaha ityukte, when you say shona eva adarahati, your lips are that is actually only that shona river, which means you're negating the presence of or the possibility of any other water body that could exist there. When you say Vaktram Bhojam Saraswati Vaktre Adivasati, Saraswatyeva Adivasati iti uktam chete, kimami anyate tatra ushitum nashaknodi. You don't want to confine it to only one particular thing. You want to keep it open so that the idea that any water body exists there, and why do you have that desire to drink? So shonayeva ityatra Anya jalashayaha navidyante iti pratitihi bhavet avadharanartakam eva padam atra anuchitam. This is more like a lesson on auchityam than dosha. As I always try to point out, when there is an anuchita padam, auchitya vicharam, and all your that auchitya vichara text should be there in your background constantly, because that is the bijam for dosha. If there is an anuchita padam, anuchita vakyam, anuchita artham, anuchita alankaram, anything anuchitam, then it will automatically fall into the section of dosha. So auchitya, understanding of auchityam is very important to understand kavyam or enjoy kavyam. Atrambojam Saraswati. This is a very small aspect. You need not take it as a great dosham that just completely removes the enjoyment of rasa. This is a thing that can be avoided. That's why he points out even a small dosham like this. So Vaktrambojam Saraswati Adivasati Sada Shonayevadharaste Bahu Kakustha Virya Smriti Karana Patuhu Dakshinaste Samudraha Vahinyah Parshvametaha Kshanamapi Bhavato Naiva Munchanti Avikshnam Swachche Antar Manase Asmin Katham Avanipate Te Ambupanabhilashah Atra Shonayeva Iti Niyamaha Navachyah Shona Iti Adharaha Te Something can be how it could come within the meter is a difficult thing to that Kavi has to look for. So we'll stop with this. The next few shlokas are all big, big shlokas like this. So we need some more time for that. Okay.
Aka for Rama.
Kakutstaha is another word for Rama. Yes.
What is the I mean how is the story behind that?
Kakutstaha, yes. Kakudi sthitva yuddham akarot. Kakutstaha, it's an Ikshvaku king who existed before Raghu, Dilipa, and all. Ikshvaku was also a king. In that Vamsha, you had another king called Kakutstha who took the form, Indra took the form of a bull, and tasya Kakudi. Kakud is that hump that is there in the bull on the neck, no? There is a hump that is there for a bull that is called Kakud. Kakudi sthitva yuddham akarot, one of the Suryavamsa Raja. I don't know what his name is. I forget his name.
So he was called Kakustaha.
He was called Kakutstaha. Kakutstasya Vamshe Udbhutaha iti Kakutstaha. So Rama, Dasharatha, Aja, everybody is called Kakutstha. Like any Aikshvakuhu. Aikshvakuhu is also a common name for all those who were born in that Vamsha, Suryavamsa. Anybody after, so Ikshvaku is not a Kakutstha. Manu cannot be a Kakutstha. Surya cannot be a Kakutstha. So it's those kings who are after Kakutstha can be referred to as Kakutstha.
Like Raghava.
Raghava, you can't call Dilipa as Raghava. You cannot call Raghu as Raghava. You can only call Aja, Dilip, Dasharatha, like Dasharathi. Dasharathi can only be Rama, etc., or Lakshmana, I mean, Chandraketu, Lava, all of those people also can be called as Dasharathi. Dasharathasya
धन्यवाद
Okay, namaste.